Feet of Clay is one heavy story. Even on this show, it goes pretty far in more than a couple ways. Part 1 does a marvelous job of setting up the characters, situation, and themes. It also excels at world building with beautiful shots of Gotham in different areas from different angles. We see new locations and are introduced to new important players. It just feels more like a living, breathing city in this episode, even more than in a lot of its high-quality predecessors. There are noir elements, there are body horror elements, and the voice acting and dialogue are fantastic at driving home the themes of addiction, body image, the pressures of fame, and more. That's all in just the first episode. At the closed Gotham Island tramway, deep into the night, Lucius Fox is seen dropping off a briefcase to Bruce Wayne, but things take a turn when Wayne double-crosses Fox and a few armed goons threaten to kill him. Batman shows up to save the day, but Bruce Wayne is sought for questioning by police. Meanwhile, movie star Matt Hagen is shown to be hopelessly addicted to a facial cream chemical that restores good looks to his disfigured face. It's revealed he's working for corrupt businessman Roland Daggett. Daggett has him impersonate others with the capabilities of the facial chemical while supplying him with the addictive substance. When he discovers Bruce Wayne is wanted by the cops, Batman does all he can to track down whoever impersonated him in his faux criminal encounter with Lucius Fox. So as I mentioned, there are a lot of layers in this two-parter. There's a ton of story to fit in, but part one doesn't ever feel rushed. It takes its time and naturally delivers the information we need to know. Right from the beginning, the episode feels off, but in a good, intentional way. It's like we're seeing Gotham through a different set of eyes. Maybe that has to do with Marv Wolfman writing the teleplay. These were the only two episodes he had a hand in collaborating on, and as the creator of Tim Drake, Dick Grayson's Nightwing identity, and much more, he was a massive influential force in comics for years prior to and after this. Ron Perlman brings a sense of brute desperation to Matt Hagen that is expounded upon later when he's turned into Clayface.
I gotta have more. Now, see? It wore off. Look! I can't fix it anymore!
The old Hollywood tone surrounding him provides excellent direct and indirect metaphors for what can manifest inside us with constant attention, addiction, paranoia, resentment, self-hatred. We see Hagen go through all of it in this first episode. He's made into a very effective, sympathetic character, which this show routinely does very well with its main villains. In his first appearance, Ed Asner nails Roland Daggett's take-no-prisoners attitude. Daggett is truly a revolting human being who doesn't care how many lives he ruins in the achievement of his own underhanded goals.
You needn't bother searching for him. When his supply runs out, he'll come to us.
With Bruce Wayne framed for attempted murder, Batman is shown crossing a few lines in this episode. He scoops up a car with the Batwing and flies it over the city with Raymond Bell, one of the men who attacked Lucius Fox, inside. He even drops the car into the river and threatens him more by dangling his body from hundreds of feet up. Batman was trying to get out of him the name of the man who impersonated Bruce Wayne, but it doesn't exactly go according to plan. When approached by a few police helicopters, really, no blimps, Batman drops Bell into a rooftop pool. Good thing he's so accurate with that Batwing and apparently knew how deep that pool was. This was one of the best times we ever saw Batman off his game. He doesn't have any solid idea of what's going on or who's involved, and even gets himself arrested at the end of the episode. Feet of Clay has one of the most tragic musical themes in all of this series. You can feel the sadness, loss, and sympathy from the first note. They also don't shy away from a few grotesque moments. I mean, they go pretty far with at least one horrific scene. The sequence where Hagen is held on the floor as Daggett's thugs are pouring an exorbitant amount of the facial chemical down the actor's throat is pretty terrifying, and showing us just the shadow made it even more disturbing. We see a tease of the effects that had on Hagen at the end of the episode, which sets us up for an engrossing part 2. And we'll cover all of it next time on Batman.